our reading picks up the words of the song, and it comes from Revelation chapter 5, verses 6 to 10. And between the throne and the four living creatures, and among the elders, I saw a lamb standing as though it had been slain, with seven horns and with seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God sent out into all the earth. And he went and took the scroll from the right hand of him who was seated on the throne. And when he had taken the scroll, the four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb, each holding a harp and golden bowls full of incense, which are the prayers of the saints. And they sang a new song, saying, "Worthy are you to take the scroll and to open its seals, for you were slain, and by your blood you ransomed people for God, from every tribe and language and people and nation, and you have made them a kingdom and priests to our God, and they shall reign on the earth." I wonder how that word "worthy" strikes you. You know, I'm by myself in the office most of the time, and sometimes I think to myself, it would be great just to call somebody, just to say hello and have a bit of company. And inevitably, I don't. I say, oh, they must be busy, or, you know, they're probably not in. I'll just keep working. And at the base of it, the reason why I don't call people is because I don't feel worthy. I don't feel like I'm worth somebody else's time. Some of you are facing rejection from other things, more serious things. Some of you are being rejected by family, rejected by work colleagues, rejected by friends. And it has left you feeling unworthy. But hear the good news that comes from Revelation, that Jesus, the Lamb of God, worthy of all praise and honor, chooses to give to us worthiness. He calls us righteous. He lifts us out of our sins, sets us apart from all the world, and calls us worthy, worthy to stand before the throne, worthy to be called righteous, and worthy to serve him as priests. That has huge implications for us. You can imagine when we pray, people listen. All those elders and the heavenly host, they listen. Why? Because you are worthy. I am worthy. When we come into the presence of God, God himself looks down at us and smiles and says, "There is my son, there is my daughter, whom I am well pleased. He, she is worthy of my friendship and my love." An amazing thing, and a good thing to carry into the rest of the day. Let us pray. Father God, we give you thanks and praise for Jesus Christ died for our sins, and we too, with the elders and with all the company of hosts, lift the name of Jesus and proclaim, "Worthy is him." And we pray, O Lord, out of gratitude and thanks, that when we come and don't feel that worthy, you will gently lift us up to remind us of our calling in Christ, of our worthiness to stand before the throne, and our role as priests serving our God and Father. And we pray this in the name of Christ. Amen. The Lion of Judah, who conquered the grave, he is David's root and the Lamb who died to ransom the slave. Of all blessing and honor.
Does the Father truly love us? Does the Spirit move among us? And does Jesus, our Messiah, hold forever those He loves? Does our God intend to dwell again with us?
You.